Let's talk now about the backup and the restoration of AF. First of all, I should point out that this is not a topic that should be unfamiliar to any of you who have done any work within the Pi server. Things like the frequency of your backup and where do you put the backup. These are things that are very common. We've dealt with them with the Pi data archive for a long time. So those of you who are longtime system managers should be really nothing new here. Some of the things we do recommend. We do recommend you do back it up on a regular basis. And by regular, that's really up to you. So if you have something that is constantly writing to AF, if you've got a homegrown application, or if you're just busy little beavers and you're constantly creating new structures in AF, then that would be something that would require a nightly backup. We do suggest you put that backup on a different physical disk. The so-called hand grenade test for backups. If you throw a hand grenade into the room and destroy all the equipment, do you still have a backup? Well, if you don't have a backup, you really haven't backed it up well. So put it on a different physical disk on a different facility or different room if possible. So back it up to some network drive somewhere outside the physical location of where your server is. Also, now there is a scheduler that comes with the SQL Server Standard and Enterprise Editions. Those of you using SQL Express, you won't have that. It does make use of this SQL agent process, so that's a process that has to be running, or I should say a service that has to be running. The SQL agent service is listed right here. As you can see, it's running on this, and typically you would find that running on SQL Server. The licensed version of SQL Server. Here's where you would find it. Under SQL Server Agent, you can find it as one of the jobs. And if you double-click on this, take a look at the attributes of this, you'll see that what we've done is scheduled this to execute on a regular basis. Yeah, if we take a look at the scheduling under Schedules, as you can see, it's going to occur every day at 3:15 a.m., hopefully when there's very little activity going on so that it doesn't interrupt with anything else. So that is something you can rely on if you're using the SQL agent and you're using the licensed version. Now, if you're using SQL Express, it doesn't have that job scheduler, so what we suggest you use instead is you will find that we've got a little backup utility. It's under the PyPC AF SQL directory, and you'll find it. It's called afbackup.bat. And this is a file that can be executed. It's obviously a batch file. It's going to go ahead and execute a backup for you. There we go. And if you do need to make changes, change the name, for example, of your instance, this is where you would do it. You'd find a little bit of information about this in the manual if you take a look in the class lecture notes. Now, of course, the first thing that comes to mind is, where is all this being backed up? Where do we actually put the backup that we've scheduled? And if you go into the SQL configuration, you can find where the default backup is. Here's where it is on my particular configuration, so I certainly don't want to claim that that's where you're going to find it on your configuration, because of course it may not be. So here's the file, this $PIFD.back, that's the backup of the AF database. If you recall, that's called the PyFD database in SQL Server, and so that's its backup. Now again, I certainly don't want to claim that that's where you're going to find it on yours. You're going to have to go take a look at however SQL Server has been configured, and I'm guessing that that's going to be a function of what version of SQL Server, etc., that you're using, exactly where the backup's going to go. Now, as in all this that I've been looking at here, within SQL Server has been under the SQL Server Management Studio. Now, one last thing is that if you do have AF, this AF server, located on the same physical computer, as the Pi system, and especially if you've got SQL Express, where you don't have the option to do the regular backup, if you've got this installed in the same directory as the Pi directory, then you will, or as the Pi system, you will find that there is a, under the root directory, on C, there is a Pi subdirectory, and you will find that there's a file called pibackup.bat. Now, Pi is not installed on this machine. This is the machine that's running SQL Server to go with the AF server, which is also on a different machine. A Pi server is somewhere else, so that's why we don't see this Pi directory. Let me go ahead and switch over to another virtual machine that does have Pi installed. I want to show you what to look for. It's under the Pi directory, under the ADM directory, stands for administration, and you'll find this file right here, pibackup.bat. Now, this does depend on which version of Pi you're using. Of course, the Pi servers that predate AF are not going to have a link to this AF backup. But what you'll find when you run Pi backup, the regular Pi backup, that's going to execute the afbackup.bat. And so that will, at that point, it's an automatic backup for you. So if you have that afbackup.bat configured properly, and again, remember that afbackup.bat, that's where, yep, let me show it to you where that is again. That's under Program Files, PyPC, AF, SQL. If this has been configured properly, you know, with the right SQL instance name right here, then that will go ahead and do the backup for you. Now there's one more file I want to mention just briefly, and I've switched back right now to my Pi server, and that is there's a file called Pi Site Backup that you'll find installed on every Pi system. This Pi Site Backup, yeah, there we go, that's actually the example. So that's a batch file that will be called from the Pi backup to do the site-specific procedures. Now, the reason I mention it now is because I just mentioned earlier that we would suggest that you move your backup to a different physical disk. Well, many system managers have learned to put those kinds of things that are specific to your site, you know, things where it's naming specific servers in your site or direct, you know, UNC references to shared drives or something. That's the kind of thing that you would want to put in this Pi site backup.bat so that after your backup of AF, you would incorporate into Pi site backup.bat a mechanism to copy that out to some, you know, foreign device somewhere or some shared hard drive. But remember, when we're talking about these directories and going in and modifying these files, we're really only talking for those folks who have SQL Express or don't have the SQL agent and the backup that is created automatically for you when we do the install on a regular licensed version of SQL Server. Let me just remind you again, those of you who do have the licensed version, you're going to find that in SQL Server Management Studio. Here's the backup that we install. And as long as that SQL Server agent is running, then you should be making a backup automatically.